Arabic learning must be easy. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Luay. Welcome to the lecture number 20 of the language course on our channel, Academia Dimashq or Damas Academy. Here we go. What shall we do today? So, in this video, we will learn about the following. Step number one is the introduction, where today we are going to get to know the number 13. In the second step, we will learn the letter number 20. And the last part of our lecture today is grammar. In this lecture, we will start with the future tense. The number 13, we say, الرقم ثلاثة عشر. الرقم ثلاثة عشر. Or الرقم ثلاثة عشرة. الرقم ثلاثة عشرة. رقم means number and ثلاثة عشر or ثلاثة عشرة means 13. We will discuss the difference between them in the future. The sort of lam in الرقم is lam شمسية because the first letter in the word is ra. We see the right way in this video. So, الرقمُ ثلاثةَ عشرَ. الرقمُ ثلاثةَ عشرَ or ثلاثةَ عشرَ. ثلاثةَ عشرَ. And now the number 13. Let's continue. Our letter for today is called Fa. Fa. The Fa is roughly written by drawing a circle with the addition of a finger plus a dot on top. There is the explanatory video that clearly shows how to write the Fa. So, as we learned in our series that the letters have different forms, the letter Fa has three forms, namely how it's written at the beginning of the word, middle or end of the word. We will see that in the following examples. And now the video. حرف الفاء. حرف means letter. حرفُ الفاء. And now the original form at the beginning of the word, in the middle, and finally at the end. Let's continue. Here we have two examples of the first form of the letter Fa at the beginning of the word. As simple examples, we have here the noun Funduq. Funduq. So Dhamma on Fa, Sukoon on Noon, Dhamma on Dal, and Sukoon on Qaf. Funduq. Funduq means hotel. And the hotel would be الفندق. الفندق. And the second example, the noun فكرة. فكرة. So كسرة under فاء, سكون on كاف, فتحة on راء, and سكون on تاء مربوطة. فكرة. فكرة means idea. And the idea would be الفكرة. الفكرة. So we notice L with the letter فاء, of course لام قمرية. الفندق. الفكرة. On this slide we have the first example from above, but with all sorts of تشكيلات and تنوين. If you have not watched تشكيلات or تنوين's lecture or would like to watch it again, you can refer to lecture number 1 and 3. I explained them there in detail. So the noun فندق without التعريف is therefore without an article. So here تنوين is used at the end of the noun, so that فندق with تنوين الفتح would be فندقا, with تنوين الضم فندق, and with تنوين الكسر فندق. As a reminder, when we are using تنوين الفتح, we must add the letter ألف at the end of the noun, as in the example فندق فندقا. Now the noun with التعريف is الفندق. We don't use تنوين anymore, but we continue with تشكيلات, so that الفندق with فتحة at the end would be الفندقة, with ضمة at the end الفندق, and with كسرة at the end الفندقي. Now the second example, فكرة, with تنوين الفتح would be فكرة, with تنوين الضم فكرة, and with تنوين الكسر فكرة. In this example, the case of تنوين الفتح, there is no ألف added because the word ends with the letter تاء مربوطة. Well, the noun فكرة with التعريف is الفكرة. We don't use تنوين anymore, but we continue with تشكيلة, so that الفكرة with فتحة at the end would be الفكرة, with ضمة at the end الفكرة, and with كسرة at the end الفكرة. Now a video to show how to write the examples. فو دو ق فندق, and with التعريف is الفندق. And the second example, فكرة, فكرة, and with التعريف is الفكرة. Let's move on. On the next slide, we also have two examples, but from the second form of the letter فاء, namely the post, سفير. سفير. So فتحة on سين and سكون on راء. سفير. سفير means ambassador, and the ambassador would be السفير. السفير. So لام شمسية, because the first letter in the word is سين. And the second example, the adjective مفتوح. مفتوح. So فتحة on ميم, سكون on فاء, and سكون on حاء. مفتوح. مفتوح means opened, and the open thing on the opened one would be المفتوح. المفتوح. So لام قمرية has a code here because the first letter in the word is ميم. So the word سفير is a noun without التعريف, so without an article. سفير with تنوين الفتح would be سفيرا, with تنوين الضم سفير, and with تنوين الكسر سفير. Now the noun with التعريف is السفير. We don't use تنوين anymore, but we continue with تشكيلة, so that السفير with فتحة at the end would be السفيرة, with ضمة at the end السفير, and with كسرة at the end السفيري. Now the second example, مفتوح, with تنوين الفتح would be مفتوحا, with تنوين الضم مفتوح, and with تنوين الكسر مفتوح. Now مفتوح with التعريف is المفتوح, with فتحة at the end would be المفتوحة, with ضمة at the end المفتوح, and with كسرة at the end المفتوح. Now a video to show how to write the examples. So سفير, سفير with التعريف is called السفير. And the second example, مفتوح, and with التعريف is المفتوح. Next, we have two examples of the third form of ف, but at the end of the word, which is the noun ظرف. ظرف. So فتحة on ظ, سكون on ر, and سكون on ف. ظرف. ظرف has different meanings. So it can be a cover or envelope for the letters, because envelope is basically a cover. ظرف can also mean situation, like you say I am in a difficult situation or a grave diplomatic circumstance, then you use the word ظرف here in Arabic. In grammar, ظرف means adverb. So the adverb or the envelope or the circumstance would be الظرف. الظرف. So لام شمسية, because the first letter in the word is ظ. In the second example, the food رغيف. رغيف. So فتحة on راء and سكون on فاء. رغيف. رغيف means loaf. It's always used with bread in Arabic, like loaf of bread, and the loaf would be الرغيف. الرغيف. So لام شمسية, because the first letter in the word is راء. The فاء in the first example, ظرف, is irregular, because فا comes at the end of the word and takes the original form, because the previous letter in the word is ra, and ra can only be connected to the previous letter but not to the next one, so partially. Here the first example, ظرف, is a noun without التعريف, so without an article. ظرف with تنوين الفتح would be ظرفا, with تنوين الضم ظرف, and with تنوين الكسر ظرف. Now the noun with التعريف is الظرف, with فتحة at the end would be الظرفة, with ضمة at the end would be الظرف, and with كسرة at the end would be الظرفي. Now the second example, رغيف, with تنوين الفتح would be رغيفا, with تنوين الضم رغيف and with تنوين الكسر رغيف. الرغيف is a noun with al at-ta'rif. We don't use tanween anymore, but we continue with tashkilat so that al-raghif with fatha at the end would be al-raghifa, with dhamma at the end al-raghifu, and with kasra al-raghifi. Now a video to show how to write the examples. ظرف, ظرف, and with التعريف is الظرف. And the second example. رغيف, رغيف, with التعريف is الرغيف. That was all regarding the letter ف. And finally we come to the grammatical part. Today we are dealing with the future tense for the first time. Returning to lecture number 8, we got to know the tenses of the verbs. Al-af'al means the verbs, and their tenses are 3. Either madi means past, mudari' means present, and mustaqbal means future. In previous lectures, however, we have always worked with the order of madi, mudari' and amr. Well, when you conjugate a verb in Arabic, you learn just like we practiced. Step 1, madi, step 2, mudari', and step 3, amr. The mustaqbal tense is usually learned separately, as we will do today. So, zamanul mustaqbal. Zamanul mustaqbal means the future tense. The alif beginning mustaqbal is hamzatul wasl, so we pronounce the two words together. Zamanul mustaqbal. If you didn't watch the lecture about the sorts of hamza, so you can refer to lecture number 5. Zamanul mustaqbal. زمن المستقبل. So the future tense has two ways of using it. Either number 1 using the letter seen with fatha on it, س, or number 2 using the word سوف, سوف. Both represent future tense, and we will work with the first one today. So letter seen with fatha on it, sa, and the question arises, when or for what do I use the seen in the future tense? There are actually a lot more than two differences, but the main reasons are two: for the near future or more emphasis. So if you are talking about the near future like tomorrow, or if we want to emphasize that we are definitely going to do this thing in the future, then we use the seen for that. Now the question, how do I use the seen in the sentence at all? Usage is very simple. Seen is added in front of the verb conjugated in present tense. For a better understanding, let's take a verb and work with it. As a reminder, the first kind of verbs called al-fi'lu thulathi, and this kind includes all verbs whose letters in madi are 3. Now on this slide we have the verb of the first kind, الدراسة, means to study. We have already conjugated this verb in our series in ماضي, مضارع and أمر. But now we need the verb conjugating in مضارع, and then we convert it to مستقبل. As a reminder, this verb in ماضي is called درس, in مضارع يدرس, and finally in أمر أدرس. We notice the verb in ماضي consists of three letters, namely دال, را and سين. Let's continue. Now on this slide, we start conjugating the verb in مستقبل, so in future tense. So number one, we have أنا سأدرس. أنا سأدرس means I will study. Number two, أنت ستدرس. أنت ستدرس means you will study. Number three, أنت ستدرسين. أنت ستدرسين means you will study for singular feminine. Number four, أنتما ستدرساني. أنتما ستدرساني means you will study for two persons. And now the video. أنا سأدرس. أ ن ت س ت د رو سو أنت ستدرس. أ ن ت س ت د رو سي ن أنت ستدرسين. أ ن ت م س ت د ر س ن أنتما ستدرسان. Let's move on. On this slide we have number 5. أنتم ستدرسون. أنتم ستدرسون means you will study for plural masculine. Number 6. أنتن ستدرسنا. أنتن ستدرسنا means you will study for plural feminine. Number 7. هو سيدرس. هو سيدرس means he will study. Number 8. هي ستدرس. هي ستدرس means she will study. And now the video. أ م تو م س ت د رو سو ن أنتم ستدرسون. أ م ت ن س ت د ر س ن أنتن ستدرسن. هو سيدرس. هي س ت د رو سو. Let's continue. Here we have on this slide number 9. نحن سندرس. نحن سندرس means we will study. Number 10. هم سيدرسون. هم سيدرسون means they will study for masculine. Number 11. هن سيدرسن. هن سيدرسن they will study for feminine. Number 12. هما سيدرسان. هما سيدرسان means they will study for two persons masculine. And finally number 13. هما ستدرسان. هما ستدرسان means they will study for two persons feminine. And now the video. So, هو م س ي د ر س و ن هم سيدرسون. سيدرسن. هن سيدرسن. so هو ما س ي د رو س ني or هما س ت د رو س ني هما سيدرساني for two persons masculine and هما ستدرساني for two persons feminine. That's it for this lecture. To practice writing the letter F, I have attached a PDF file in the info box below. You can print it out and then take your time to practice writing with it. I have also prepared a small quiz, which you can also print out. And finally, I summarized the content of the lecture in a third document. I hope that the lecture was easy and understandable for you. So, good luck and see you next time.